and gentlemen, today we will be presenting our Boston Back Bay that we redesigned.
So this is the top-down view of our design, and this is how it looks compared to the surrounding.
This is the first thing we'd like to talk about, our focal point. So we were inspired by the circus from Bay Bath in England. This was one of the inspiration pictures that we found, we reviewed in our 20 pictures. As you can see, we inspired this, and we, instead of making the trees our focal point, we replaced it with a fountain.
Okay, order and variety. So we were inspired by New York City because all the buildings are in order and in neat rows, but there's a lot of variety in the shapes and sizes, and there's also a lot of greenery. So we incorporated that into our design because all the buildings are the same and they're all neat. But we added a tennis court, and all the corner buildings are shaped differently just so all the buildings are exactly the same.
Now this is, I would like to talk about how our design was compact and also dense. This was our inspiration from Paris, France. As you can see, there are a lot of buildings and a lot of things to follow your eye through. However, there's still a lot of open space and a lot of denseness and also a lot of openness so that there's a different variety. And this is displayed and evident in our design too, because as you can see, there are a lot of buildings that are shaped similarly. However, there's still a lot of order and also a lot of denseness, and it has a lot of space to open.
Okay, visible light. So we got our inspiration from Barcelona because of all the busy streets and there's always light around. So we put that in here. So we added a tennis court and some seats for people to just sit and socialize and do whatever they want together.
Now there's a conclusion. I think that during this urban design class, we learned a lot, and we were able to, what I thought was a perfect urban design. This was because we had all the elements that we learned in our classes. We have all of these six elements here, and we were able to make a perfect urban design place. Now I would like to end this presentation with a video of our whole our whole thing.
Going in team drive.
Going in their team drive.
Which team drive?
Next up, we've got Dave and Georgia.
Paris,
From these beautiful cities, we decided to make it local and compact enough so that people can see each other, but not too compact that people feel claustrophobic. To keep some tradition in our Boston Square, we made the building brick. Our buildings are also basic cubic cubes, rectangular prisms.
We learned that the focal points are key to a great city, park or anything. Our design's focal point is a large fountain in the center of the square.
What I like best about our design is how comfortable it is. It isn't too crowded or too simple. It also has many different facilities so that people can come to the square for most of their needs.
In conclusion, our design for Back Bay Plaza is a simple one. It has natural beauty.
As well as stores and other buildings and facilities that is well-balanced and serves multiple purposes. A source of entertainment, a place to get clothing, food, and other necessities, and a place to just enjoy yourself.
Our design doesn't include tall skyscrapers that tower over everyone and make you feel minuscule, but instead buildings with only around 5 or 3 stories. It's a local place where you can meet and greet as you go about your business. Back Bay Plaza is a place that follows the rules to make a successful city area.
Thank you.
Area. This is a picture of the square. You can see we use buildings to shape the shape of the square. We have here the opening in three dimensions and the library here. And here we have the pool, the square, and one of the other side openings. And here's a little animation. So this is an aerial view of our area. It shows the three courtyards and the 10 buildings. You can also see the trees, well, the tree, the pools, and the larger and smaller entrances.
We made our buildings many different shapes and sizes to make the space more unique.
Our focal point was a tree in the central courtyard, and the outer courtyards had no focal point other than the pool. The tree is clearly visible from the larger entrance, as the poles are flatter and provided less of a focal point.
A shady and more intimate space was created by the tree, with benches added for a space to sit and relax in the shade of the tree.
Although the courtyard with the tree was smaller and provided a shady place to relax, the courtyards with poles were grander and would seem the purpose of larger events and gatherings.
The pools were not meant for swimming, but rather as a decoration to make more space, to make the space more interesting without having three courtyards, without having three courtyards with the same pool.
The path through the pools not only looked pleasing, but also created a passage for people to walk through from one side to the other, because walking around the whole pool would be incredibly inconvenient.
There were smaller passages on the sides of the taller, skinnier buildings, and these provided a space to walk out of the area and less space between people's buildings, fostering a greater community in the area.
The buildings helped create a bowl around the central space and create a still open but intimate space. The different heights of the buildings worked to make a more unique space.
Of course, the presentation would not be complete without different styles in the same building. So to make the presentation more interesting.
Hello, I'm Peter, and this is Andrea. Our project was redesigning the building. Okay, so this is a whole view, like a bird's eye view, of our design. This is our building. These four rectangular things.
These are the things that are surrounding.
So basically, in urban design, we learned that a good design has to have a focal point. So it kind of gives people a destination of where they're going. So we decided to put this, I actually don't know how to call it. When we were doing the project, we called it a gazebo, but it's actually not like a gazebo. Okay, these are more pictures of our focal point. This is the whole view, and these are just like doorways and stuff.
Our inspiration came from Boston Common. This is where our inspiration came from the building. And Piazza di Campo in Rome, Italy.
So when we were talking about this picture was not exactly the same, but it's this picture. When we talked about it, we said that for a good plaza, so when you are standing at one end, you need to be able to see the other end to make it like comfortable. It can be either too crowded or too large. That would not have this nice, cozy feeling.
Block
is also a nice place to have a stroll, walk, to have a cup of coffee. So in our whole thing, the hedges are kind of like small, separated places where it's like quiet while the whole thing is another side of it.
Also, some of our buildings are like